Although I made a few videos on color grading, still many people used to ask me on Instagram that what is the easiest software to color grade. So I might have found the easiest software to color grade and color correct, and it is called 3D LUT Creator, and I definitely love it. So I would like to recommend that software to you. This software basically creates a 3D LUT, so you can use that 3D LUT in any software which supports 3D LUT, for example Photoshop, Premiere Pro, After Effects, Final Cut Pro, DaVinci Resolve, or basically any of the softwares which supports 3D LUT. So technically you can use it anywhere because it's a 3D LUT, so you can just try it out. And before you ask, it won't work for Lightroom, unfortunately. Sorry for the lack of videos currently, I was busy with other stuffs and projects, so couldn't make videos consistently, but I want to get back to YouTube and make videos more often for you guys. So if you haven't subscribed, please hit the subscribe button. I really want to hit 50k soon, so please. And if you have any questions or any suggestion for me, then you can DM me on Instagram, so go follow me over there as well. This noise inside some death thing, it's only one more day. Hey guys, I'm Prithviraj from PR75K, and this is 3D LUT Creator. You can get it on both Windows and Mac. The best part is that you can match colors using a reference image. I'll cover that in the later part of this video. I'm gonna just show you certain things about the software. Like, you'll have all these options, like you can edit by color channels, volume, AB grid, CL grid, curves, 2D curves and mask. I personally use the AB grid. You can have up to 32 grids. You can change it by clicking it here. You can either open an image which is open on your Photoshop itself, or you can just simply go to file and open image. I have this picture of this girl sitting. As you can see, as I move my cursor over the photo, there's this cross which signifies the color in the Spider-Man grid. Yep, let's just call it the Spider-Man grid. The lake kinda looks very dull, so we will find out that exact blue color on the Spider-Man grid. It's that point over there. So once we move it, you will see it affects the color of the image. Let me just make the greenish blue look more blue by dragging it. There's some yellow grass behind her. How cool will it be if it was red? Let's just find out. Yep, the red does make it look better. At the bottom, you'll see some basic adjustments like brightness, contrast, tint, etc. You can play around with it if you want to. Now let's check the before after, so hit on compare. As you can see, we have successfully graded the image. You can save this color profile by hitting on save 3D LUT in the bottom and use it in your photos and videos. If you want to grade your videos, then simply take a screenshot from your videos and open it over here, save your grade as a 3D LUT and then use it. If you want to know more about color grading your videos using LUT, then just hit on the I button just right now or check the link given in the description. Let's check this out with another image. You can change the color of the whites by dragging the point at the center. You can see the results by yourself. I'll give a slight bluish tint to the whites. And let's make the yellow a bit more orangish. You just need to play around and see what works the best. Like, I am changing the blue color into a little more teal or turquoise color. Now let's just compare the two images. One of the best features I like about this is the match color feature from a reference image. Go to file and select, load a reference image. For example, I am using a photo from Justice League so that I can show you how you can get that DC theme going on in your photos. Yeah, you can get the Marvel theme as well, so go start a war in the comments on which is better, DC or Marvel. Once you have opened the reference image, go to edit and click on auto match colors to reference. It will take up a few seconds and then you'll see the photo took the color of your reference image. You can further adjust it from here if you want to. Just have a look at the Spider-Man grid. It looks amazing. You can save this 3D LUT and continue editing on Photoshop. To use it on Photoshop, open Photoshop and go to adjustments and hit on color lookup and select the LUT you just saved. In Premiere Pro, you just create an adjustment layer and open the color workspace and apply the LUT from the Creative tab. So if you're interested in the software, then I've left a link of this software in the description so you can check it out and buy it if you want to, or maybe just try the demo version and see what it has to offer by yourself. And if you think that this video was helpful, then please hit the like button and also subscribe to my channel for more such videos like this. So anyways, thanks for watching and I'll catch you in the next one. Till then, hasta la vista.